world full of mundane podcasts, one show rises from the ashes. Critics are calling it outrageous. Podcasts, as we know it, will never be the same again. Tonight, prepare for an epic journey where every step could be your last. The destination, a place where no maps can show. The mission, to rise above the rest. The danger, unimaginable. The reward, a shit ton of weed and laughs. It's going to blow your mind. This is To Be Blunt. So sit back, turn up the volume, grab your weed, get ready to light those blunts.
We're back, episode 27. In studio, we have the Scott.
Woo, baby, I'm here.
We have Frank Knox.
Woo, woo.
And your host, the P to the double EZ. And we are back with a big episode here. Before you know it, we'll have a guest in studio coming all the way from Philadelphia.
Oh, wow.
That's right.
The home of ECW.
Home of ECW, home of those cheesesteaks.
That's true, that's true. And he's going to be bringing a plethora of infused delicacies.
Ooh.
What are we talking?
I don't know if I want to spill the beans. He gave me an exclusive. But one of the things, Frank, that I know you like, empanadas.
Hey, empanadas!
That's right.
Francisco Knox over here.
Empanadas. So we have all kinds of shit, I guess, he's got. We're going to talk to him about his career and his life as a cannabis chef. It's like Bon Appetit right here in the studio.
Sounds like a good time, man. I better order the Uber now, huh?
That's right. We don't have to order Domino's this week. We got the phone lines open, 860-384-7110. If you want to call in to the show, please do. Frank Knox has all the big NFL playoff news from the weekend. We got a lot to talk about with sports this week. I can't wait. As you see, I'm flossing.
Yeah, I know. He's got it on.
I'm flossing.
He's flossing, baby.
That's right. No selling with the Scotch should be interesting this week as we're a week away from the Rumble.
I know. It's coming.
It's going to be crazy.
My favorite event of the year.
Yeah, that's your
favorite event.
I would have to agree. That's definitely one of my favorite events also.
So excited.
You know, Royal Rumble's the beginning of WrestleMania, you know, the road.
It is the road to WrestleMania. And it's also one of the biggest parties of the year. That's the Scott host.
Yes, that's right.
Scott, are we going to have the Rumble sheets this week? Or next week?
Next week. Next week I'll have the sheets ready. Maybe we'll even post them on the site if anybody else wants to get in on the action.
We might as well post them on the social media. So let's get those sheets ready for next week. Give the audience a chance to participate and see if they can take down me, Peasy, or the Scott.
That's a good idea. So we throw the challenge out there. See, so what happens is the Scott puts out a sheet for everybody who comes to the party.
That's right. So it's all the different things that can happen in a Royal Rumble. So you get three choices for every category. So, like, for example, the first question I think will be, like, who's going to win? So you get three choices. If your first choice is right, you get 5 points. If your second choice is right, you get 3 points. If your third choice is right, you get 1 point.
An example of a question would be...
Well, that was one question, like, who would win? But then you can have who will be eliminated last. Same thing.
That's right.
You get to choose your three. Who's number one? Although we know who number one is this year.
Surprise entrance.
Question number two. Surprise entrance. Who do you think will be number 30? Who will have the most eliminations? Who will last the longest? Who will last the shortest? And then there's probably some bonus questions on top of there. Like, I could ask a random question. Maybe it'll be worth, like, who knows, maybe 10 points to say... How many suplexes does Brock Lesnar deliver in the Royal Rumble match?
Really?
Something crazy, you know? So we'll have to wait and see when I get it all done.
And we will
have
those for both the men and women's Royal Rumble?
Yeah, that's right, man. Ever since they started doing two Royal Rumbles, it's extra sheets, man.
So you're telling me I got to get there even earlier now? So you're going to tell me again?
Well, luckily, we're going to have them up next week, so we'll be able to, you know, make ours at home.
You can do it by hand, but I would say, like, you got to have her prepared. If you're not at my house by 7 o'clock... Then I would say have it texted or whatever, but you got to have your final answers in by 7 because it could be the first match on the card.
Ideally, Scott, what I'd like to see happen, Frank might agree with me, is I'd like to have the sheets here for next week.
We've already established that.
We just said that. I'll make sure they're here next week.
There's
You're going
to
have them in studio.
Challenge to the audience to take down me, Peasy, or the Scott.
Listen, I don't ever come close to winning.
You know, if someone else wins, we're not going to put them on air. But, you know, we're going to have the audience... Try to beat us. More importantly, the Scott.
I want to talk more about the Scots because there's one piece that I like about this that we haven't discussed yet. But before we go any further, because we're talking now, and I got this sitting in front of me, and that's a loaded King Pop.
Ooh, baby.
How can we delay this?
I don't know.
Because we're a little nervous about all the infused edibles we're going to eat this year.
Well, I mean, yeah, we're also talking the Royal Rumble, and it's a good topic because... It's really one of the biggest events for us of the year, and there's money on the line. So, before we go any further, I'm going to ask the two of you, are you ready?
Oh, we're ready.
I'm ready, man.
I said, are you ready?
Let's get ready to light that blunt.
Then, for the three of us in this podcast studio, and the hundreds listening at home or watching live on the Facebook stream. Let's get ready to smoke it! Tell him, Frank!
And if you're not down with that, we got two words for you.
Smoke it! That's right! The King Palm is loaded. This might be just what the doctor ordered today. After a long, shitty day. What's gonna top it off? Than the loaded King Palm. That's right. And for anyone wondering, inside this King Palm today, special strain.
What we got?
Platinum Jack's Cookies. That's
wow.
Right.
Is that we've had Platinum Kush before. It's got to be a variation off that, huh?
This is a Jack Herrera mix with Platinum Cookies, which is also a hybrid of Platinum Kush and Girl Scout Cookies. Yes.
Speaking of Girl Scout cookies, that time of year again, folks.
That's right. I know. Get your boxes in.
I think I already placed an order.
Smells like cherry and lime candy, so they say, with a dense resinous buds that are light green in color. The sativa, which is dangerous, produces a very giggly, alert, and euphoric high with a general uplifting feeling.
You and sativas, I don't know. We better get the doctor on speed dial.
If I end up with a panic attack in 20 minutes, you know what to do. I wish I had one of those lifeline gimmicks.
Unfortunately, man, I don't know what to do. Do you want me to call 911?
I got medicine upstairs for this. Everything goes to shit. Right. Scott, what are we drinking this week? What is the beer of the week? Because I left you hanging last week.
That's all right. The beer of the week, and Peasy, I know you're all about this one. So it comes from Alvarium. It's a relatively local brewery over in New Britain, Connecticut. And they have one that they're known for. It's called Cluster Nutter. This is a variant. And this is actually, if you're watching on Facebook Live, this is a first ever crowler I've ever purchased. So it's a quart of a beer in a can. And this is, I mean, it smells delicious. This is a salted chocolate peanut butter pretzel stout. And it is delicious. I think I like the original a little bit more. It might be a little bit better on tap, but this is absolutely phenomenal.
Peasy, you're drinking it. What do you think?
6.9 percenter.
Okay. So I had the Cluster Nutter.
Yep.
The OG.
The OG, which you remember from right before Christmas.
Right.
Super good.
This one,
it's still good, but I honestly am not a big pretzel fan.
I love pretzels.
I hate pretzels.
My mom loves pretzels. She's obsessed with them.
Okay, let me actually clarify. I don't not like pretzels. I don't like the hard pretzels that come in a bag to eat. I like soft baked pretzels. Yeah, okay. that kind of shit.
Dripped
like.
In butter with like nacho the, cheese,
with a little
sauce.
Beer cheese on the side.
The
Bavarian giant
Wetzel pretzels
that comes on a hook.
Yeah, pretty much. I'd even get little pretzel bites. You get at the mall. I don't give a shit.
I love those. Those are buttery deliciousness.
Oh, that's what I mean. That's what I mean. So. I actually don't mind it, but I prefer the one without the pretzel. That's my only complaint. Because gotcha. I feel like I can taste it, you know? And it tastes like the crunchy pretzels.
I'll tell you, though, out of all the peanut butter flavored, like, stout beers I've had, this one, though, is the best. Like, this brand, the Cluster Nutter, like, family.
Let me get back to the Royal Rumble. Because there's a piece of that. There's a piece of the Rumble that we didn't talk about. And that is when the Scott busts out his lottery ball wheel.
Oh, yeah.
That thing is rigged.
That's a separate side bet thing.
It's broke.
It's like a miniature. It's really a bingo cage is what it is. But it's like a mini like Royal Rumble tumbler. And basically it's a bingo cage. And, you know, the bingo goes up to, I think, like 65 or 70, something like that. So I basically like take out all the numbers that are after 30. So there's 1 through 30 in there. And then for both Rumbles, you know, we just I spin it. And then like for like $2 a ball, you get to pick.
$2 this year. I thought it was $1.
It might have been one because I think since it's been two Rumbles now, it's like, you know, people come over, you know, everybody doesn't want to spend too much money. So we're a bunch of cheap bastards. But
this is true. We are a bunch of cheap bastards.
So you draw your numbers, and basically it comes down to it'll be like two numbers will end up winning. Like one number will get basically like 75% of the pot if that number entrant wins the Royal Rumble. And then whoever's the last eliminated, whoever that number was, they'll get like the other 25%, whatever, for that Rumble. And it's double because it's like it's both Rumbles, so... It's a
question for you. After the Rumble's over, do you return the bingo balls and use it as bingo on, you know, non-Rumble season?
No, dude. It just, like, stays in, like, my laundry closet room, all like, right. All year long, and then just comes out in January.
So you only bust it out once a year, and it's for the Rumble party.
That's right, man.
See, I didn't know that.
Or sometimes...
I thought he was playing bingo on the side.
I mean, if...
He's running his own bingo league from his house.
The bingo hall.
Scott's going to be live on Facebook next week.
It doesn't happen. It only comes out again if there's, like, say, a greatest Royal Rumble.
How can we use that thing for the show? That'd be sick.
That is a good idea. We gotta think of something.
We gotta think of something to bring in the ball.
Let's think of something if anybody's listening. Got any ideas?
We're gonna have to take out some balls because I figure the only thing we could use it for is to do something times that quantity.
Very well, could be. But what would we do? That's a good point.
We can make up 30 gimmicks and. We each have to do one. It'll be like the roll of death. So we each make up 10 gimmicks. Like, you know, you have to dress in a pirate uniform for one podcast.
What?
Draw number 7, you have to dress
up. But you have 6 months to do it. So there'll be these side bets we'll have to make.
Maybe this is what we use for when the Scott actually gets stumped. So when the Scott gets stumped and he loses, he's got to spin the wheel. To see what the punishment's going to be.
20 slaps in the face.
I don't think I like this idea.
I don't know. I think this is actually a good idea.
10 kendo stick shots to the back.
That wouldn't be that extreme. It wouldn't be that extreme, but that's not a terrible idea. I mean, if we do like, you know, 15 balls and each number coincides with a punishment, whether it's, you know, wearing a dunce hat for the week or taking chops from Frank Knox like we did for the King of the Ring.
My only gripe with that is what would be his reward when he won every week?
Yeah, so he's able point. To. Like he's not going to go home and fucking cry himself to sleep.
That is true.
Let's be honest here. Every time he's lost, the guy's bummed out for 48 hours.
Yes. Anytime he's lost, he's Googled the question. You know, ask the question, you sure, man? You know, he always tries to do.
Then it gets to the point I have to research. Then I have to like call like some counselor or something to help me through the situation. But I make it through though.
Wow. I mean, I don't know, dude. There's been times where like you've like texted us in our podcast group chat and been super like fucking depressed.
That was the first time because it just kind of came out
the
of nowhere.
The first time.
And I was like,
with the Al Snow.
The first time I got stumped and I was like, you know what? Maybe this isn't for me, guys.
Well, you know, in defense of you, you're getting some very bizarre questions of, like, Deep South Wrestling and NWA.
Oh, there it is. Holy shit. All right. Oh, man. We got all kinds of shit going on here.
Wow, right? Our special guests are here.
Our special guests are here. Damn, bro. I didn't know you were coming in with full trays.
Oh, dude, I thought you guys were bringing some food.
Wow, what?
Jeez.
Ah, right. Man, Scott, help him clear off the table. Put the jars and the bongs on the shelf. And just showed up right here live from Philadelphia.
Yeah, he's here.
ECW original.
I wonder if he's from West Philadelphia, born and raised.
I don't know. Boy, I don't know. Is he from West Philadelphia, born and raised? I don't know. You might have to ask him. He's not born and raised there. From Wallingford. That's right. We'll talk more about that.
Putting CT on the map down in Philly.
This guy's got... look at this. Look at this.
I wish the audience could see. I wish we were, you know, had cams.
We do. And Scott could take
the
camera.
Scott, where's the camera? Where's the camera, Scott?
I guess I got to move the whole thing. They're going to stop right there. What you're looking at are trays of infused foods here. Right. Bring it back, Scott. Bring it back more. Stop it right there. A little more, bro. There you go. All right, you're good. That's right. Let's go on the podcast. It's getting nuts here.
It's a good time for a commercial break.
There's only two stoners, right? That's also true. You got a good point. I think what we'll do is we'll take a quick break. And when we come back, we're going to...
Introduce the guests.
See
what we got to eat?
Listen, I'm afraid to even know what's going to be inside these things, bro. After looking at this... I'm nervous. So we're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to talk to our guest chef, Goop. Goof. Sorry, I said Goop. Goofs, I already hit the blood, so you know it's going down. It's going to be dangerous. And then we're going to talk to news, sports. We're going to no-sell with the Scott. And we're going to go in depth right here on the 2B Blunt Podcast.
All while PZ wears his Titans shirt today.
Go Titans!
We hustle. Been attempted but cannot be
assessed. Instructions are we hustle. For an attack by an unknown. Yeah. What we doing around her, man? Hustle. I got that white stuff, call it Larry Bird. Yeah. I'm on the corner hustling, flipping me a couple birds. I got the J's calling, I'm pulling bees and herbs. Oh. And if you wanna smoke, well, I got time to burn. Yeah. Flip peas, smoke kush, this is what I do.
You know it.
White lines laid out, man, they're coming too. And I don't play no sports, but this the NBA. No brown or light, only green up in this place. I hear police coming, I'm finna get away. Woo, woo. Made a clean getaway. Couple days later, man, I'm moving pounds of hay. Back so loud, everybody body shake. I ain't a snitch. Somebody lied, I got a pound up in the trunk and on the side of 45. Black box, blue light, digital, I'm pushing trees. All you wanna be, just wanna be me. I ain't a snitch. Somebody lied, I got a pound up in the trunk. I got a pound up in the trunk. I got a pound up in the trunk. Yeah, light on the trees like it's December 25th. Pull it in, hold it and let it out and take a hit. I'ma burn today like it just might be my last. I got everything you need, you just need to go and ask, bitch. I just re-up, you know. Look like some big blocks. Mm-hmm. So much weed that it'll never fit in Ziplocs.
Nope.
Vacuum sealed bags, man, them shit's looking hardy. Mm. Bust the seal, now it's about to be a reaper party. I hit it. Now my eyes looking kinda low. Every thought that I process, man, is kinda slow. 23rd bar, got a Michael Jordan flow. So I'm getting in, this ain't a free throw. I'm making slam dunks, it's money in the bag. I always win, so I will never wave no white flag. I'm stashing duffel bags, I know you bitches jealous. But when it comes to money, PZ simply overzealous. I ain't a snitch, somebody lied, I got a pound off in the trunk. I got a pound up in the trunk. I got a pound up in the trunk. Yeah, light up in the trees like it's December 25th.
bullet and hold it and let it out and take a hit. I'ma burn today like it just might be my last. I got everything you need, you just need to go and ask, bitch.
Right, 2B Blunt Podcast, we are back.
We back, baby. We back.
I got a little crazy in here for a second. Our special guest right here, Chef Goof in the building. Let me turn your mic up. What's up? Say what up, man.
What's up? How's it going?
All right. Holy shit, man. Let's make sure he's all good to go.
We got the red solo cups. Oh, yes. No.
Yes, yes.
The solo cups.
So we got some THC syrup in that.
This is some syrup.
The rest are for you, too. Yeah, so it's like a simple syrup, so it's pretty much just, like, really sweet. So we just mix it with some tea, and...
Is it, like, weed lean?
Yeah, I guess. No. I put it in a little bottle to make it look like it's weed lean, you know, just to kind of market it, but it's a simple syrup. That's all it is.
Wow, so you got syrup in the cup. We got mixed in here with a little sweet tea.
Yeah, it's good.
I know, it's like a... I don't know how to explain it. It's kind of like a thicker syrup.
Yeah, yeah, it's a nice thick.
It almost makes it like a nectar.
I wanted to
make a sweet southern tea, bro, is what the first thing
but
I thought.
But it's like
of.
Thick like a nectar, though.
A green sweet tea.
It's Scott. Scott no smoke, bro.
You want a sip, bro?
I mean,
you can take a sip. Yeah, you
these guys have like outed where I work, you know, in the real world. But, you know, maybe off camera I'll take something. I don't know.
Where do you do that, Scott? We're not supposed to say it first.
Well, I'll see. I may or may not. So they can't prove anything, right? If anybody's watching that doesn't like me.
Damn. So Chef Goofy brought a whole plethora of food for us to try, yes, which is going to be insane. So throughout the show, high. You're probably going to see us eating. As we're going.
You're going to eat, you're going to feel full, you're going to get high.
You want to tell the people listening or watching online like what exactly you brought?
I brought some beef and cheese empanadas that's infused. I got some pie filling that's made with like strawberries, blueberries, and some blackberries. It's also infused. I brought some goldfish, I believe, some smart food popcorn, some flaming hot Cheetos, and a couple cereal bars for you guys to try out.
Holy shit.
Wow. Yeah.
Wow.
We smoke good, we eat good.
That is your motto. That is the motto. Exactly. You smoke good, you eat good. So,
it's a deep lineup.
I know. And I'm wondering if we should try one thing now. Well,
you guys
I go further into the show.
The beef and cheese empanadas, you want to start, you know?
Yeah, we'll try those.
I'll try an empanada.
We want to be able to let you know, like, you know, how we feel.
Yeah, by the end of the show,
I made them a little while ago, so they might be, like, a little, they're not going to be, like, as fresh, but, like, you know, I'm driving around, getting pulled over by the cops.
Wow, you got pulled over by the cops on your way
in? Dude, it was, like, wild. Like, we pulled out, and we're, like, the minute he pulled out right behind us, we're, like, oh, we're getting pulled over. So, of course, he does. He comes up, and he's, like, he's giving us, you know, all the shit that we don't have a registered car and whatnot. And then,
well, I mean, it's true.
Meanwhile, like he pulls up and I have three trays of food on my lap and I'm like, wow, this all has weed in this. Like they're like,
wow,
you fucking cop.
So we got beef and cheese empanadas right here.
Yes,
on a 2B Blunt podcast that are infused.
That's a great empanada, man.
Uh huh.
I mean, flavor on point.
Holy shit!
It smells really good.
Wow,
dude, they said crunchy. I'm so fucking pumped that that said crunchy. That's dope.
Wow.
That's awesome. I'm so happy about this.
Yo.
Wow.
Wow. Isn't that good?
Oh, holy.
It's like delicious. Yes, we like.
It's amazing.
So far, so good.
If this is the first that we're starting with, we're in trouble. I shouldn't be doing this on air. I'm just like mumbling through it now. I'm going to take one more solid bite.
Everybody's like hearing nom, 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 nom.
That's all they're hearing right now.
We're eating.
Listen
we're
to
drinking.
PZ eat.
Wow.
Tonight on PZ Eating. 7 p.m.
Bro.
It's Bon Appetit featuring PZ. Yeah, and Chef Goof.
Bro.
Your host, PZ.
Terry, what the
fuck? It is beefy. It is cheesy.
Yep.
It's delicious.
It's literally everything I could want in an empanada. And you don't taste shit, bro.
That's what the logo is. You know, me smoking, eating an empanada. It's pretty much my thing.
Are the empanadas like your signature item?
The reason why I came up with it is I was doing events out on the West Coast, and I just wanted to do like a street food and just do like, I wasn't even doing like anything infused. I was just like, I just want to work at weed events and just sell food. I want it to be street. I want it to be easy for them to walk around and get their shit. So I was like, well, fuck it. I'm Puerto Rican. You have to do something in Spanish. You know what I mean? Something Hispanic. Like,
so you went with the
empanadas.
I mean, it makes fucking sense.
I started filling it with mad shit. And then I was like, well, I got to get high at the same time. So let's see what we can do here.
Well, I mean,
it's delicious. I can't stop eating it.
I know. Well, that's trouble.
I'm in big trouble.
That's a big trouble. At least you can eat yours while we get into the news. Which we're going to have to start with, because if I don't do the news now, we're fucked. In a half hour, we're going to be useless, bro.
I know. If I thought you guys were already like high by hour number two, like, I don't know what I'm in for tonight.
Well, I don't fucking know what we're in for, too. So before we go further, let's get into a little news, yo. Right here in the 2B Blood Newsroom, when it comes to the best of the world news and sports, right here, you get a live on 2B Blood. And our first headline comes to us from Dunedin, New Zealand. That's right. A man was on vacation in Asia for a month last July and August, and his daughter helped him with rent his home out to a few women through Airbnb. For the first couple weeks, neighbors saw many men coming in and out. And everyone started to start wondering what's going on. Next thing you know, they got to call a fucking plumber. The electricity's up to $600 a month. The guy doesn't know what the hell's going on, right? These two women staying at his house. He's got no clue. And what happens? They find out that they were using the Airbnb as a brothel.
Oh, wow. Wow, they should have got a fucking Ring doorbell, right? And then everyone could have watched the porn going on inside that house.
Dude, I'm talking. Can you imagine? That's you rent out needed. Your home to two people?
Hey, you probably would have been selling the videos on Pornhub for a profit.
Dude, it's just... I mean, you got a plumber? Like, the guy found out that they had to call a plumber because there was some kind of pipe leaks, right? I wonder if the guy had to go and lay some pipe while he was there.
Pipe layers of America right there.
That's right. So the guy had to complain to Airbnb, and they decided they were going to reimburse it. $500 for 20 hours worth of cleaning that needed to be done to the house. Because it's probably full of stains and nastiness. Oh, you know?
Sex juices all over the walls, carpets, everywhere.
$70 for missing bath towels, $200 for a plumber, $800 for an electrician. I mean... They offered to get him counseling and a security system. I mean, that's nice customer service, you know? But I don't know, 20 hours is even enough cleaning for that. You rent your house out for a month? 2 months?
Oh, wow. Here comes a joint.
What the hell is that?
It's a smoking.
Oh, utensil. For fuck's sake. Here we go. Our next headline comes from God, I can't even talk, bro. I can't even fucking talk already. What a fucking mess. We're coming from overseas right here in Ukraine, where a man awoke to find his wife had placed a metal chastity nut on his penis while he slept.
What the fuck?
That's right. That's what I said. The unnamed man in his 40s woke up in pain and, you know, found out when he realized where the pain was coming from, that the lady had put a metal nut over his penis. Can you believe that?
I don't even want to think about that.
No, it gets worse. The man had to get taken to the hospital. Because now he's like, how am I going to get this damn thing off? Right? He didn't have the proper tools. So neither did the hospital. So they call an EMT rescue crew who had to cut the choker off with a grinder saw.
What the? Bro, damn, dude.
With a grinder saw. You know, I just... I can't imagine.
She was able to get it on him while he was sleeping?
Oh, yeah. She found out he was cheating on her.
She put a metal nut on his shit?
That's like that Lorena Bobby.
Damn, wow. Shit. That's the hardest nut to break, too. The metal nut.
I mean, can you imagine? Could they come in with a grinder saw? And they're saying, we have to put this near your shit.
I mean,
if she got it,
can you imagine you sitting there and sparks start flying? You know,
love is in the air, baby. The sparks are flying.
Oh, dude, I don't know. That was a rough one, if you ask me. But we got some more stuff right here coming to us live from Walmart.
Uh-oh.
Scott's going to love this. You know, an employee of Walmart, which we call out every fucking episode.
Walmart Scott.
A woman made a bomb out of stuff she found at Walmart was the headline. And I couldn't believe it. So they're saying a Florida woman. Of course, it's fucking Florida.
Of course it
you
is.
You know, that's where all the bullshit happens.
It's a Florida woman this time, though.
Yeah, well,
whatever. A Florida man.
Florida woman arrested for allegedly making a bomb inside a Tampa Walmart. So Emily Stallard, 37, was in the store with her child, which is the most fucked up part. She got her kid there.
Wait, she made it inside the Walmart?
She walked in empty-handed.
What she started building it in the carriage, probably.
A security guard noticed her wandering aimlessly through the aisles for more than an hour, opening odd items such as nails, a mason jar, denatured alcohol. The security guard began watching her closely and alerted an off-duty police officer. The two men were able to stop Stallard right before she lit a wick. Yeah, she made a bomb in the store using items she found in the store.
With her daughter.
With her daughter.
That's the more fucked
teaching
up.
Teaching young, you know, you gotta.
I mean, if she wanted to know what she gotta do, she could have had her kid look up, you know, the instructions on the internet instead of just walking aimlessly around the store for a few hours looking real hot.
Scott, is there a list of ingredients that make bombs given to the Walmart employees to alert them?
I mean, I guess there is somewhere in the store, apparently, if this lady was able to figure something out.
Oh, yeah. You go right through Walmart. I saw a bomb at Walmart the other day. $2 in the fucking bin. X-Men, Dark Phoenix. You want to talk about a bomb? That shit bombed. The next headline comes to us out of Texas. This guy comes here with infused foods. You want to talk about some fucked up foods. Texas is about to have the Testicle Festival.
Oh, fuck yeah. Nuts in my mouth. Oh, Oh, shit.
That's right. Happening this Saturday in Bankers Smith Hall in the town of Fredericksburg. Testicles from calves, lambs, roosters, turkeys, and other animals are apparently considered delicacies down there. Now, I don't know about y'all, but I'm not eating any nuts. You know, I don't even like fucking peanuts, bro.
Rocky Mountain oysters, it's like a big thing in like Colorado. It's like bull testicles or some shit.
Well, who the fuck would do that?
I don't know. I never had them. I know I said nuts in my mouth, but I never had them.
Sounds like something you'd eat on Fear Factor or something.
Yeah, I remember seeing things like that. Yes, yeah, for $1 million. Will you eat these rat testicles?
Can you order just one, or do they come in pairs? You have to have two. You know, that's a question. You know?
It's like I guess it depends if the animal had testicular cancer. I mean,
you got to be nuts to be running a testicle festival,
oh,
right?
Boy.
Oh, there we go. Oh, yeah. There we go.
That's right. The last headline. This is one blew me away. All right. Gwyneth Paltrow, famous for a lot of movies, including Avengers.
You know, Iron Man.
Yeah, Iron Man's woman. You know, 47-year-old actress.
She's hot.
And a lifestyle entrepreneur found another way to shock the world with the sale of a vagina-scented candle in her store.
Hell yeah.
Called the Goop Store, which is where I got fucked up and I said goop with this guy because I was reading this fucking thing.
Man,
The candle, provocatively named This Smells Like My Vagina, no lie, will run customers a cool $75 and boasts a fragrance packed with geranium, citrusy, bergamot, and cedar. I don't know if I said that right. And this is the craziest part, right? It says this candle started as a joke between perfumer Douglas Little and Gwyneth Paltrow. They were working on a fragrance, and she blurted out, "This one smells like my vagina." And they decided to roll with it. And apparently now, it's currently sold out.
It's Gwyneth Paltrow.
Sold out.
It's her vagina.
Can you believe it?
Shit's fire.
Wow.
Sold out. So
that many people want to smell her pussy.
Yes.
I know one amazing person that does. And that's Tony Stock.
Well, that's it for news headlines. Let's go into sports with Frank Knox.
When it comes to sports, there's only one man for the job. The best analysis in the game right here from the 2B Blood Newsroom. It's Frank Knox.
And Frank Knox is here to bring you the hottest news of the week. As you heard, three managers have now been fired due to the Astros sign pitch calling scandal.
This is huge news.
Huge. And today, Carlos Beltran was released from the Mets after he was just signed to a long-term deal to coach his first team.
What?
He was involved as a player, along with manager A.J. Hinch, and now Red Sox manager Alex Cora, who both have been fired due to this scandal. And keep in mind, the Astros and Red Sox have been dominating the Dodgers year after year in the World Series, and they've been cheating by banging on trash cans to do so.
Oh, no.
So the whole baseball world is in uproar. I mean, to me, this is worse than taking steroids, because at least back then, everyone was doing it.
I mean, you got a point.
Yeah. And as I previewed on Monday night, not only was The Bachelor on, but the NCAA championship game was on, and LSU pulled it off. They won in grand fashion, dominated the second half, won the game 42-25. But for me, the reason why is in the third quarter, the staple of the Clemson defense, Jake Solowski, the linebacker and captain, was ejected from the game from targeting. And this guy is the legit only real threat on Clemson's defense. And he was taken out of the game for targeting, and he was thrown out. And at that point, Joe Burrow and LSU gained control and skated to victory easily. But man, you know, we got to go back to Sunday. Because how about the Tennessee Titans, BZ?
That's right, baby.
Derrick Henry.
Woo!
Now they ran into Baltimore. The whole crew, including Tannehill and Vrabel.
That's right.
And they locked out Lamar Jackson in the Baltimore Ravens.
That shit was crazy.
Beat them.
They
Nobody
had
knew what was happening.
The whole game.
28-12. They won.
And not just by a little, by a lot.
By a lot.
By
they
a lot.
Dominated them.
That's right.
Derrick Henry, 203 all-purpose yards.
He's an animal.
And like, he threw for a touchdown. Like he was Tim Tebow.
That's
with
right.
The jump pass.
That's right.
You know?
Titans are on fire. Kobe. Right
the Kobe. Titans are on fire.
That's right. You know what happens next week.
But they're going to Kansas City.
That's right.
Kansas City was down 24 points at home. But they prevailed. They beat the Texans. They ran out of fireworks because they scored too many touchdowns. That offense is the fastest I've seen all year.
I don't care.
You got Harmon, Hill, McCoy, Mahomes. I mean, Kelsey. And it goes on and on and on and on and on. I don't even know they have Sammy Watkins.
We shut down the Patriots. We shut down the Ravens. And we're coming to Kansas City. And we're shutting down the Chiefs.
Not this year.
Just like we did when we discovered America.
Wow. Yes. Wow, and you're not right. You are right on that. I'm sorry. That's not right.
That's not right.
But anyways, moving over to the NFC, we had the Niners win in easy fashion.
Those are my boys.
They eliminated Dalvin Cook, 6 carries, 18 yards, something like that.
They know what time
I mean,
it is.
If you're going to hold the best player that played in football, at least in fantasy football this year, Dalvin Cook, one of running back, that's their whole game. Vikings have nothing else besides the run first to open up the pass, and it didn't happen because the front line of the Niners are just too dominant. They've proved it all year.
Damn.
So they're going to be playing the Packers, and I think the Niners are going to prevail at home. The Chiefs are going to prevail at home, and we're going to see Chiefs-Niners in the Super Bowl in Miami, where I'll be there that weekend partying and enjoying the game.
That's right. We're going to be live.
Be living it up down there, huh?
That's right. You're going to be live from Miami, baby.
So, I mean, I don't know. I'm going to end on this note because this is what I, you know, I discovered last night that there is an Aaron Hernandez documentary. I don't know if you guys heard about it on Netflix.
What?
A 3-part docuseries called, like, The Killer Inside, The Mind of Aaron Hernandez.
That's interesting. I saw a commercial for it. It's
and kinda... they broke down his childhood through his whole life and, like...
He lived, like, right near us, right?
He's, yeah,
Bristol, Connecticut, which is, like, 20
Central.
Minutes away.
I mean, this kid was a beast.
I remember, like, Max Preps in high school. I remember seeing him on, like, Max Preps as one of his top tight ends.
This kid was a beast.
I'm also a Gator fan, so I knew about
Florida
him.
Florida Gators, Tim Tebow, they chronicled that, how he was shooting dudes everywhere he went, just acting out, and no one really stepped in and did anything for him. But really? I don't know, it was a weird angle. They worked, like, his whole gay life into it, and it having problems with his sexuality. And it was a very interesting take. If you guys haven't seen it, you like murder docs, you like sports.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I definitely checked it out, and I enjoyed every minute of it.
I got to check it out. That sounds like it'd be something good.
So it's a three-part right now. It's just what? Part one's aired? Or
no,
all
it's just
there?
All there. All three episodes.
Okay. So you're going to binge watch it.
Yeah. It's a one-time shabam.
Damn.
One-time shabam.
Look at this room right now.
Smoked out.
I know. It's very hazy up in here.
So, I mean, who do you guys coming out? I mean, we know you got Tennessee going to the Super Bowl. But who you got coming? Packers, Seahawks? Who are the Titans playing?
Well, your lady's a Packers fan,
yeah, that's
right?
It's got to be Packers.
Oh, that would be a Super Bowl for the ages. Yeah.
Packers for the Titans.
Yeah, the household will be divided for sure. I wonder which way Bannon and Harvey will turn. They'll be the deciding factors. Scott, who do you got?
If that happens, I mean,
I'm asking you, who
overall,
do you got overall?
I think it's going to be Niners.
Niners versus who?
Yeah.
I'm. You know what? I kind of want the Titans to
Niners,
make it in there.
Titans. All right. So who do you got?
I'm gonna have to go Niners Titans.
Niners Titans. All right. So I'm Niners Chiefs. I'm the only one with a unique pick here. Anyone else out there wants to call in and give us your Super Bowl predictions after these championship games? Hit us up 860-384-7110.
That's right, Frank Knox with sports.
That's it, yes, sir.
Let's get into a little no selling with the Scott.
And now, bringing you the best and worst of pro wrestling today, the smartest mark in the building. He is the Scott.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, no selling with the Scott is back. So, let's get into it. What was lit and what was the shits for the week in wrestling? So,
wrestling.
I'm going to start off with what's lit. We already know that Raw is just the shits, right? It's terrible every single week. But if there was one shining light that came out of Raw this past week, it was R-Truth. I mean, his segment with Brock Lesnar.
That's exactly when I tuned in, actually.
It was amazing. It was hilarious. And, like, if you're someone out there that takes that 24/7 title, like, too seriously, then you're making a mistake. Because it is only meant to be a comedy title, and that's what it is. And R-Truth is just absolutely hilarious. It's great. It gives Brock Lesnar the opportunity to associate with and give that mic time or interact with people who he wouldn't normally interact with. And we're going to see more of that because with him being number one in the Royal Rumble, he's going to have that opportunity to interact with people from, could be from NXT, could be from SmackDown. You're going to see him interact with people that you would not normally see him feud with. So that was a great segment. That was the shining light of Monday Night Raw. The rest of Monday Night Raw, though.
Scott contact.
Oh, God.
The rest of Monday Night Raw, though, was the shits. One thing I want to point out, did you guys see the ref botch?
I watched The Bachelor and the NCAA Championship.
Yeah, you were watching that. I want to say this was during halftime, though.
Good night.
But
thank you, man. Glad you agree. Someone in this room does.
So, there was a great match on Raw. It was Aleister Black versus Buddy Murphy.
Oh, I did see that match because
it was the third match. Yes,
every time they're in the ring together, it's magic.
And it is magic. But as you see, like Raw is very repetitive. We have that match again. We have Andrade and Rey Mysterio again. We have the same Rusev Lashley freaking feud that's been going on for what seems like an eternity now. It's just keeps being repetitive. But in that match, it looked like it was the end. And Buddy Murphy's shoulders were down for what looked like a three count, but the referee didn't count three. And I don't know if there was miscommunication, but the referee said no, his shoulder was up. Watch it back. His shoulders were down. He wasn't moving. It was a three count. But they had to improvise based on the referee, so they just went to the finish one more time, right? Anyway. Another thing.
What else are you supposed to do?
I mean, that's what you got to do at that point. It's live TV, right? Yeah. Just like this is a live podcast. So anyway, My next person, he would be on my shit list, but he made an apology this week, so he's all right. And that's Triple H, okay? So he's mad enough to apologize for some remarks he made about Paige. All right? And it seemed like, I don't know if it was like a business call or whatever he was at, but it seemed like the 97, 98 Degeneration X Triple H came out in this interview, and he made an inappropriate remark about Paige. But let's not forget. I mean, come on. Do you think Triple H forgot that Paige used that NXT women's title as a cum plate? I mean, let's be honest. I know you've seen the pictures in the video. I mean, come on. You're
calling a cum plate.
Anyway.
What does she do in a cum plate?
You look it up. Just search it on the internet. You'll see what she did with that title, or what Brad Maddox, I guess, did to it. Anyway, my shit list, and that's going to be Justin Bieber. And you're like, Justin Bieber? Why is he on the shit list of wrestling? Well, earlier today,
hey, yummy, yum.
John Cena issued a challenge to Justin Bieber. There's been some back and forth. I guess Bieber did a face plant on a unicycle or something. So there's something like that. So there's been all these memes, and he put out a meme, I guess, on his own Instagram where he's falling off this unicycle, but he changed it so it looks like he's like jumping off the top rope, and it's on to John Cena. So earlier today on some talk show, John Cena made a challenge to Justin Bieber based on that photo.
It's all work.
And he's like, I challenge you to WrestleMania. But let me tell you.
So Justin Bieber they admit that he has Lyme disease like 3 days ago. Then here comes John Cena. Never give up, kid. Fight me at WrestleMania.
Did he really admit to that? Because I didn't know that. Well, now I feel terrible with what I'm about to say then. But what I was going to say is if this yummy dummy, okay, if he accepts this match and he's part of WrestleMania, dude, I will cancel my WWE network, okay? But if what you're telling me is true, then I wish him the best in his recovery of that.
It's Lyme disease. You know, people have Lyme disease, just get bit by a tick.
It's like a normal thing, right?
All
right.
Yeah. Well, I just don't want to see him.
It's as common as herpes these days.
Don't want to see him at WrestleMania.
Treat him the same problem.
All right. Anyway, so what's lit? Let's talk about our boy doing the thumb pose with me. Rob Van Dam, all right? Mr. RVD, right?
Who needs two belts when you got two bitches?
He is living his best life right now, okay? He's got his girlfriend, right? What's her name? Katie Forbes, right? Have you guys ever seen her in person in life?
No,
I haven't. Impact.
Well, you've seen her on TV.
You're saying in the flesh, like you do.
Oh, dude, like.
How does she smell?
She looks.
I was at WrestleCon earlier this year, and I saw her, and I was like, God damn, when I saw that ass, all right?
God damn.
So.
Yeah, she's got to be donk, 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 donk.
RVD's living his best life. That's his girl. But what's the even better part? Is his girl has a girl. So this guy's over here with two honeys, okay? But apparently this week on Impact, they did a sex scene. And it was so over the top that they've now been banned. Impact Wrestling is banned from airing on Twitch streaming.
Fuck Twitch TV.
Which is crazy.
Yeah.
Which, I didn't know that RVD and Val Venus switched gimmicks. Like, I didn't know that happened. But anyway.
I mean,
he's living his best life, man. We fully support Rob Van Dam, his two girlfriends.
We do. And if he wants, he can start his own streaming service, and he can name, like, the first episode, The Hole. That's H-O-L-E, the whole fucking show. Anyway, so back to the shits, okay? And I'm going to leave it to, speaking of Impact, right? So this person, Tessa Blanchard, she is the brand new Impact Wrestling Champion, right? I'm not taking that away from her, but some things came to light this past week. A lot of things. But what I'm going to bring up is the fact that if you have $100, this came to light, if you have $100, Tessa Blanchard will take that $100 from you, and she will record an audio of herself taking a shit. So, I never knew
what
that this segment...
What is going on right now?
...of lit and shits, that I'd be talking about actual shits in this column. It was only supposed to be, like, a word of phrase. It wasn't... We weren't really going to be talking about this. But a lot of things came to light about Tessa Blanchard, and there has... She will, for $100... will record herself taking a dump, an audio version, by the way. Sorry.
Wow.
And
wow.
Yeah, that's right. It's weird, right?
Does it come with like a selfie? Her on the toilet.
You wave
$100 isn't a lot of money.
You wave $100 bill at her, that bitch will chug some Miralax, and she will be ready to fucking record for you.
Wow, that is some extreme shit, bro.
Yeah, extreme shit, literally. And this has been No Selling with a Scott.
Yeah, it's the hippie, Dickie Moon, man. It's time to sit back, relax, and chill. You're tuned into the 2B Blunt Podcast with Frank Knox and Peasy.
Peace!
So that was quite an interesting segment, Scott. Thank you.
The second week in a row, he literally talked about shit.
I know. Last week it was Ivar taking a dump in his tights, and now like Tessa Blanchard will record for you.
Listen, I just want to know. We got past all that shit, literally. What I want to know now is what's the next thing we're going to try?
Let's go with the pie filling empanadas.
Pie filling empanadas.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
We're going to switch it up.
It's kind of like
I feel like I got to try something else. I mean,
what's pie? What is it? Just like regular pie?
It's just like I'm trying to get like I'm stoned. Okay, so
no, it's all
good. This. I'm trying to think of like you know like those dollar pies you used to get at the store. Like,
yeah,
that color, yeah.
So it's like that, but this one's like with strawberries. It's like the same flavor, like type thing. So, but it's gonna be with strawberries, blueberries, and blackberries. It's fucking fine.
Berry mania.
Yeah, it's gonna be
fuck, dude.
Dude, it's gonna be great.
Is this gonna be bad for me to work the board after eating this? Am I gonna end up with sticky fingers?
The first one was really good.
A little bit.
I'll keep it over here, and it won't go to waste. I'll tell you that.
You guys got your whatever.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's
gonna be good.
I know exactly what he's talking about. The dollar pies that come in the shape of a pie.
Yeah. I know what you're talking about.
The little drakes.
Yeah.
Like those. Okay.
They're coming in a circle.
Yeah, like the Hostess or Drake's, I think I want to say. I don't know.
It's like the same thing. Wow.
That's right. Damn. So now we got the empanadas in house. Shit's going down. I got my man, Chef Goof, right here, live in studio.
That's it.
All the way from Philly.
We're here in Connecticut today. I'm from Connecticut.
That's right. So we're gonna get to know the chef here who's made all these delicious foods that we've tried so far.
It's been good. The empanadas were fire.
Dude, a beef empanada was the super fire.
This pie is fire, bro.
I can't wait to try the pie.
It's delicious.
I can't wait to try the pie.
I don't want to eat anymore, but you guys have to.
Great.
Wow, this is a bad
sign. I've been eating all fucking day, dude. This shit is just like, fuck, dude. We were at my house, dude, and like, we were just like pacing around. I'm like, all right, do we leave now or do we not leave now? What do we do? All right, let's go. Let me get fucking pulled over. Whatever. Buffalo wings are next.
Damn, bro.
Let's get them. Yo, can we get him a couple buffalo wings on the plate?
I'm down to try a wing, yeah. That's good. I was able to refresh my palate from the sweetness of the pie.
Yeah, maybe take a sip of water or something.
All thing I got over here is beer and lean.
I got a little THC lean.
Beer and lean right now is all we got available for chasers right now.
Your coffee's empty?
No, that's actually a good
point.
There
you go. That's the best thing to recharge is a coffee.
I need a recharge. Oh, my God. Look at this.
So I must ask, you put the weed in the sauce?
Or? Yeah, it's in the sauce. I made a THC buffalo sauce. And then I fry the wing and then just toss in
a THC buffalo sauce.
Yeah.
This is really good.
It's a good fucking buffalo sauce.
It's a solid buffalo sauce.
I'm like buffalo sauce god. I will fuck anybody else's buffalo sauce up. Like, I live by that shit.
Wow.
It's good.
I'm so jealous like of you guys.
Wow. Sauce boss.
That's really good.
Sauce boss.
So Fort Scott can't even eat none of this shit. We're grubbing in front of him, and he won't even like,
dude, because it's like, oh, it's like just a plain old good, like you know, like it tastes like the like it's not like one of those things that like just tastes like a bunch of weed.
That sauce is good. It starts off a little sweetness, then all of a sudden it's just got this like kick at the end. It's like what you want. It's delicious.
Yeah.
What's that I hear over there? There's a virgin wing available. Is that what I just heard?
No way, Jose.
No?
No way, Jose.
Maybe. Oh, yeah, this one? Oh, okay.
They brought half a tray of virgin wings.
No, I didn't bring any virgin wings. There's buffalo sauce on all those motherfuckers. I know that shit for sure. Do not eat a wing if you do not want to get high. Fuck that.
Sorry, Scott.
Wow, you fucked this whole gimmick up right there.
He got real excited.
He's really stoked. It's okay.
Yeah. I am.
Listen. Let's not get off hand here. Bro, you've been in the game for a while. All right? You've been a chef for what? 16 years, you were telling me?
Oh, I fucked that up.
That's all coming in there.
So I've been a chef for about 16 years. From Wallingford, Connecticut, so I worked in a bunch of restaurants over there.
How'd you get into the chef game? Is that something you always wanted to do?
Dude, it was just a job at first. I was just like a kid, you know what I mean? You just started picking up a dishwasher job, just trying to fucking, I don't know, buy some weed, you know, buy some beer.
Yeah, right. So you were working just to get paycheck to... Yeah.
And then, I don't know, I had an opportunity to become the head chef at a restaurant in Wallingford. It's called Knuckleheads.
Yo, do not... Shut the fuck up.
I love Knuckleheads.
Me too.
Place I've ever had pig wings.
Yeah, okay. So I was like the dude that linked up with the owner that like created all that crazy shit, all that menu and all that stuff for like 5 or 6 years. So, like, it was up till then that I did that with him. We built the place. It was a little 12-table restaurant. To a big bar. You know, he put all those taps, all those
dishes. Yeah.
Shout out to Knuckleheads, Anthony Morgillo. That's my boy still. Like, he's what made me be like, this is what I want to fucking do for the rest of my fucking life.
I like that 100%. Shit. I like that place.
Yeah. It's good. It's solid. So, you started making, like, the sauces...
Yeah.
At the bar is when you started got into like.
Yeah. It was kind of like he would come up with some crazy shit and then he would just like give us the freedom to kind of just like experiment. And he like didn't bitch about it. He's like, as long as you can fucking sell it, let's get it. You know,
Did you ever not tell him that you were putting weed in this any of the sauces?
No, that would be more like an at home thing or like late night when the restaurant was closed thing, you know, but not.
So you end up working at a restaurant and then you get made head chef.
Yeah. It was kind of like right off the bat, we both didn't know what we were doing as like him being a restaurant owner and me being a chef.
Right.
And it just like, it came to step by step, built a team and whatnot. And
you guys built quite the empire there.
Yeah. We did our thing for a while, you know, winning barbecue competitions and stuff like that. And, you know, they're still killing it. Those kids, they're still Quade. I hired him. He was my sous chef for a while. He's the man. He's still doing it out there.
Same guy still there?
Quade, he's the head chef now, yeah. And he's still there doing his thing, and he's running a tight crew still, just like I did. And I guess they're still putting out good products because they're not closed, you know? So,
right.
Like,
right. So, you're running that gimmick for a while, and then why did you leave Knuckleheads?
It was just one of those things that it was just time to kind of like grow and expand my wings and start learning from, you know, other chefs and other restaurants and other cuisines.
And where did you go from there?
I kind of just like bounced around a little couple places in like New Haven and stuff like that and like, you know, tried it. I was like, oh, well, maybe I don't need to really work that hard. I could just like make pizzas or something.
There's a lot of good places to work in New Haven.
Tons of good restaurants.
You know, but then I was like, all right, it's time to get serious. And I started working. I got offered a position at Tap and Vine, and I was working under a chef there. He was a kid that I actually grew up with, and he moved here from like Mexico, didn't know any fucking English. And now he's like a head chef of a restaurant, knew perfect English, was running shit really good. And it was nice to kind of just learn under him some like newer things other than just flipping burgers and shit like that, you know.
Oh. That's awesome.
Yeah, it was nice. It was a good experience.
So, you working in Connecticut for a while. You weren't obviously at the point making infused foods.
No, that was more like at home, you know, snowstorm. Let's see what we can do in a crock pot.
That's always the best time. Yeah, that's the best way to try.
You know, hope the dog doesn't eat your bowl when you're passed out or something.
Oh, God, I know. It's always a danger when you leave anything out.
My poor dog had to go through a lot of fucking shit with us eating edibles. Poor dog.
Jesus Christ. Oh, boy.
Long live Cheech. Long live Cheech.
This guy had a test lab. You know?
Poor fucking dog.
Test animals.
Oh, man.
So from there, you ended up in California, right?
Yeah, so I was just... It came to a situation, I was working at this Italian restaurant in Wallingford, which was great, you know, but I just got kind of tired of the whole, like, I don't know, being small town type shit, and I just decided to quit my job and just go out there. I had, like, $200 in my pocket, was going to stay with my sister, and I was like, I landed, and it was just one of those things, it's like, whoa, you're in L.A., and we're driving in the car, and she's like, well, what the fuck are you going to do? I don't know. I didn't think that far ahead yet. I guess I'll just get a job working in a kitchen somewhere. And she's like, well, out here, you got to be like professional and like get a resume and shit like that. And I'm like, nah, you fucking don't need to do that. Well, she was right. It was totally different beast than what I was used to. Like, I wasn't ready. Like, I wasn't ready professionally as a chef. Yeah, I wasn't there yet.
Yeah.
And, it was crazy because I, you know, so I started working at like a pizza joint.
See, you're catching. I'm mostly rubbing off on you over there.
Yeah, so I was working at a pizza place, and it was just, you know, it was weird. It was like right down in downtown LA, like near fucking Skid Row and shit like that. You were just like, oh, this sucks.
Later the pizza out there fucking sucks. It was too horrible. So you're working at a fucking.
I was just like, you guys are jokes. This place is a joke. So I did the thing, the right thing. I got a resume together, and I started applying at places. I'm like, you know, culinaryagents.com, Indeed. You know, just other websites like that. Until finally I got an opportunity to work at this place called Nua House, which was this like crazy ass, like office sharing space for like Hollywood executives, like, you know, producers, models,
really?
Actors. Yeah. So like it was this huge, it was the old CBS studio. So we did like weddings and stuff like that. Like, and we had a rooftop movie theater, you know, like,
what?
Like if the Emmys, like their post party was at our spot and we catered it.
Oh, wow.
So it was like fucking crazy. HBO, like Mazda. I remember like them picking up a car with like a crane to put it on top of a roof for like for a party of just like 400 people, which is like some people were like, that's a lot. But we were used to doing like 1,000, 1,100 people. Like,
you guys would cook on site at the place?
Yeah.
The party?
So there we had the restaurant that was a la carte, and we had like, you know, we had the events, and we also did a rooftop movie theater that was a la carte and stuff like that. So it was a big kitchen. And that's where like it kind of transformed from being a cook to a chef. Like, where I started to like learn more from the people, my coworkers. They were all from different countries, so they would just like teach you their cuisine during family meal. And it was kind of like, it was an interesting experience. Like, and that's kind of where the Goof Drop was born, because we just like to get high. And I was like, hey guys, I know how to like
kind of. Well, you're in California, so I mean.
Yeah, well, I was. But trust me, that was fucking the weed out, man. Fuck, love that place. I love California.
I do too. My brother lives out there.
Oh, dude, I love going out there. I'm actually going to be out there in March. We got a booth at Kushstock. We're going to be selling empanadas.
You're going to be at Kushstock.
Yeah, I got a booth. I'm going to be a food vendor. Yeah, Kushstock 9 to be exact. Yeah, dude, it's like 10,000 people.
Where in California are they doing Kushstock?
Dude, Adelanto in the middle of the fucking desert. Dude. So trippy, dude. You're just like literally a baseball stadium in the middle of the desert. You're just like, yo, this is some creepy shit. Like at night, it's like tumbleweeds. It's dark. It's not, I don't know. It's cool.
The desert. Really, yeah, California's got a lot of desert. I love the desert in California. It's a good part of it.
It's good temperature and shit like that.
So, you're in California. How long were you there for?
I was there for about a year. We'll say about a year and a half, maybe.
So, then from California, you somehow then migrated to fucking Philly.
Dude, I found
out. How do you go from California to fucking Philly?
I fucking was like, yo, I'm gonna.
Even Will Smith went the opposite way.
I know, dude. No, he's my boy. I love him. No, he's not my boy. I don't know him at all.
Yeah, Will Smith's my boy, man. I love Will Smith, man.
I was watching Fresh Prince.
I love you some Will Smith. Yeah. Bad Boys for Life, baby. Yo, dude, this weekend. Today.
Oh, shit.
Today.
Is it today?
Today, tomorrow?
I think
tomorrow?
It's today. No, Thursday.
Is it today? Yeah. It's the 17th. Yeah. Right? When's is today the 17th?
Today is the 15th. 16th.
No, today right Bad there. Boys for Life came out, for sure. But, yeah.
It's probably that's tomorrow, but some theaters, they do it a little earlier.
Listen, yeah, man, they always do
I'm going to fucking see that shit, dude. That dude, Martin Lawrence reminds me of my father so much, dude. Like, same exact dude to the T. It's like, yeah, fuck that.
Well, how the fuck did you end up in Philly, though?
Oh, dude, I moved there for a chick. And yeah, so like, you were like, all right, cool, let's do this. So you land in Philly, and you're just like, so used to California, and weed, and like,
yeah,
starting to grow a business.
Totally different.
The Goof Drop was like coming up out there and everything. You know, I was like, I was starting to do little events out in the West Coast. So I was getting used to doing that where like it was just like they were big, but they were small sessions. And I was just the food guy. You know what I mean? I was infusing things. I was doing empanadas, the buffalo wings, shit like that. People, I was starting to catch a little name. But I was like, whatever. It's about to be like a downtime. There's no festivals anyways. So like the festivals are in the summer and shit like that. The big, right. Big ones. I was like, I'll just fucking go to Philly, get my money up, and then just come back out here and do it during the summer. You know what I mean? Like, but in Philly, it's not like that at all.
So what did you end up doing in Philly? How long were you down there for?
I've been in Philly for a year. I'm still there now. Yeah. So
how's that going for you?
It's good so far, man. It's like, it's cool. Like, I got a, you know, me and that individual, we didn't work out, so I ended up.
That was going to be my first question for you.
Yeah, right? Nah, she, you know, we're still good friends and everything like that, but yeah, we didn't work out, so I started, what ended up happening was when we broke up, I came to Connecticut, and I was with my boy Tommy Guns over there, and we were chilling. He's just like, yo, fuck it, dude. Just like, just do the Goof Drop. And I'm like, what the fuck? He's like, you know, I had a pound of weed at the house. I was like, you know what? What do I do with that pound of weed? It's kind of, it was really shitty weed. I'm not gonna lie, it wasn't like anything. Well, like, what super better? Good.
I always say, if you got shitty weed, the best thing to do with it is to
make it edible.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. So I just was like, all right, I'm gonna go back. He lent me like $20 to buy the packaging, you know. And I was like, I had a couple bucks to go home and get like the fucking stickers and shit like that and butter and stuff. And I was just like. So I went back to Philly, and I was like, all right, you're going to do this. You're going to build this business. You're going to get your own place. You're going to do it here in Philly and then start expanding. You got to start where you're at.
But weed's not legal out there, right?
No, it's medical and shit. And yeah. It's like the scene is like it's starting to happen now. There's starting to be events and stuff like that. I'm getting booked up left and right. Like the past 2 weeks has been crazy. Like
it's kind I of saw like the other weekend. You,
dude, went. I got another one this week and then one a week after. All right, so the next one this week is actually – it's dope. It's I'm gonna be the private chef for a ladies' night. It's gonna be like chicks doing chick shit, like, and I'm the only male that they're. I'm like, dude, what? Yes, of course, I will do that for you. What? Awesome. Oh, yeah. Yes. What do you guys want? Some salad?
That's right. Like, so you're trying to do more of these like private parties and shit.
Yeah,
right?
I'm trying to be like a personal chef. You know what I mean? I'm trying to be like, you know, where you're getting a 4-course meal or you're doing a catering.
Infused or not, yeah, though, right?
I could do both. I mean, if you really want something that's not, you know, I got you. Yeah. I'm always going to do something where it's like I balance it out. If it was infused, you know what I mean? You'll have THC and CBD. Also like dishes in like a 4-course meal. Stuff like that. So, let me get you guys. Yo, can you guys give me the popcorn? Let's get them. So, I want to. You guys try the popcorn? I've been eating that shit.
The popcorn. It's time for a movie. It's time to watch Bad Boys for Life.
Bring all the treats over here.
Popcorn, bro.
Yeah. So I got some goldfish, some popcorn. Oh, no, these are jalapeno cheddar. Oh shit!
Right. Oh my god. All
right. Here, put some on your plate. This is like the smart food popcorn right here.
Popcorn me up,
yeah. Yeah, it's gonna be dope. Let's get. There you go. There you go. All right, cool. Good. It's good shit.
Better save some for my wife, yo. She'll go nuts.
She's gonna. I have some leftovers of shit. You guys are gonna be able to take. You know, just keep. I don't fucking want them. I don't want to get any more high.
Holy shit, bro. Bro, those popcorns are straight potent.
Yeah, they're prone. Yeah, I know, because they're I was supposed to do a lot of shit the other night, and I ate this too much.
What?
You want to combine my popcorn and give it to your wife? You said you don't want to eat it because she...
No, I got shit to do here.
We got more shit you guys are going to try, too. It's like, you know, you don't...
Yeah,
like
I don't have to eat it all.
Like, at some point, somebody's going to be stoned. I'm stoned.
I am already there, and I still got to run the show, goddammit.
Well, I'm down to try a little bit of, you know.
Yeah, so we'll go with these jalapeno cheddar. Here, jalapeno cheddar Cheetos.
Holy shit, bro.
What is I love these. Right? I love Cheetos. Yeah.
What is going on? Look at the sky. Scott's like...
This is funny shit. All right, so I go back to Philly. I start making cereal bars. I make like 130 cereal bars.
The Cheetos are great. Love them.
I'm like, yo, man, like, I need to fucking get money. I need to get my own place. And I was like, all right, let me fucking do that. So I start hustling, like, cereal bars. I talk to my buddy Dougie. I ask him, I'm like, yo, man, you went through a breakup, and then you quit your job and started your business. I see how successful this kid is now, dude. This kid is fucking, dude, he made, like, 6 figures last year. Like, he's doing his thing. And he's like, to me, he's like a marketing guru. He's like, bro, start a Facebook group, private Facebook group, just add people. And I was like, what do you mean, dude? I was like, just that fucking simple. He's like, yeah. He started giving me, like, instructions on, like, you know, trying to interact with people and use, like, the Facebook algorithm, you know, and all that good shit, technology shit, which I don't know. I don't know any of it at all. I just scroll on my phone all day just to, like, and just, like, invite people or people invite people.
Right.
And now it's, like, you know, it's, like, 530 people or something like that, so... I started doing that with the cereal bars, just taking a few pictures and just, like, handing out people that were in the group. And, you know, they were just, like, showing me some support and some love. They were just, like, placing orders left and right. Like, I was, like, before I knew it, I had to take a trip, like, back to Connecticut with, like, 150 edibles or 200 edibles. I was like,
wow.
I was like, yeah, I got to fucking, like, I got to pay rent now. I got shit to do. I'm not splitting it with nobody no more. Like, I'm all by myself in this fucking city.
So now you're making trips back and forth. You're doing shows. Your fan base has grown tremendously.
Yep. It's grown between the Philadelphia. We could say Philadelphia. I have a friend in Alaska that copped off of me. I got Houston, Texas, Virginia, a big Tennessee fan base so far. North Carolina.
Peasy loves Tennessee.
Maine,
Tennessee.
That's right, baby. Maine, yeah. California, Vermont, you name it. Actually, shout out to the UK and shout out to Portugal. Just had two customers from there. Wow. So recently, I was like, what? They found me on branching Instagram. Out, I was like, what? I was like, if this was really real, this is cool. But if I don't know what, I, you know, it was an Instagram thing.
This guy's so going overseas, bro.
I was like, fuck He's it. Let's try it. Let's go.
He's expanding.
Listen, I knew what time it was, okay?
Like, it's a good thing we can only see the back of his head.
Yeah. Right? Don't show him the logo. Wait. Oh, God damn it.
True. I think it might be too late for that. It's already been on the social media.
Listen, so it turned into from like being something like that where I'm just trying to sell to make money.
What are you putting on the plates now?
All right, so I have a Flaming Hot Cheeto. I won't put too many there.
Oh, these are Flaming Hot. These things look wet.
Yeah, well, what it is, it's like they've been like room temperature, like the oil kind of starts to come out of them a little bit, but they're good.
Oh, my God. Look at this plate. Look at this fucking play, bro.
Like a plate of snacks.
I gotta snap this for the social media because this is ridiculous, bro.
Yeah,
this is ridiculous.
Got a plate full of snacks. We got the potatoes. We got the popcorn.
Hey,
fucking high.
I'm high as fuck.
This is a beautiful looking stoner plate, right?
The chicken wing was on point. The empanada was on point.
Scott's eating everything.
Fucking Scott's the guy.
Scott's the guy
you want to see.
So you got cereal bars over
here. I do. We'll wait a minute. This is where it all started.
Bro,
little guys right here. I don't have the logos on them, but this is it. This is where it all started.
What type of cereal is that?
This one is a Fruity Pebbles. And then this is a Fruit Loops.
Wow, speaking of cereal, I got five favorite cereals. I know.
Bro, I meant to freaking bring you one. I should have brought you one that was like a chocolate one. I think I have an Oreo at home or something. The Oreos.
So you started this with cereal bars?
Yeah.
Like, that was the first?
That was the first thing. It was the easiest, dude. It was the easiest, and I had a pound of weed, and it was like, it turned into where I was like, all right, well, now what do I got to do next? I was like, you got to make new shit. You got to make a new menu and shit. So it was like, you know, use social media and your favor at that point. Just start posting things on all social media aspects, hitting up people, trying, you know, talking to returning customers, offering my services wherever I can. And if I have to, I'll go there, you know, and I'll do it.
Yeah, but you'll make anything with weed?
I will make anything you fucking want with weed.
So if I'm like, I want some, you know, veal parmesan with some pork meatballs.
Yes.
You're going to make that with weed.
If I want pistachio ice cream.
Yeah, actually, I've been working on ice cream in my house. I've been working on it, like vegan ice cream, too. Listen, all this shit, like, well, not what you guys just ate, but these cereal bars, well, actually, the Cheetos, and actually the popcorn. Actually, it's, like, vegan, technically. Well, not vegan, it's, you know, it's, like, there's no dairy in it. Because I don't use, even for, like, my butter, I use a plant-based butter. And that's where I make the cereal bars with and the popcorn with. So it's just, like, you know, somebody, like, I did that because my homegirl has a freaking lactose allergy. And so it's just like, I don't want her shitting. It's my homie.
That's a good point. Are you little,
She'll be on the Scott's shit.
Yeah, she wants to get high. I got to get her high. I got to get the baby girl high, you know? So it's like, you know, make it with plant-based butter. So I do that with everything now. Coconut oil, olive oil, you name it.
It's probably, it stays better, you know? It's
yeah,
the shelf life has to be better because there's no dairy. If there's, you know, it's probably better off for the product anyways.
Yeah. It's easier to work with it.
Damn, yo. Well, I'm fucking lit right now. I'm fucking lit.
We fucking, that's how it is, you know? 2020, this is what we're doing.
This is what happens. We're going to take a quick break when we come back. I guess we'll get into the parody for this week. I wasn't going to do it, but I think I might do it. You know?
If you got it, do it.
We still got to eat cereal bars, you know?
We still got to eat cereal bars. Let's take a quick break when we come back. About to be moaning.
May I'm high here. May I'm high as hell.
I love to smoke weed in hand.
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 May I'm high as hell.
Get high.
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 I love to smoke weed in hand.
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 Let go. Haters be riding my dick. I'll be back on the block and I'm sipping a fit. You question me, I'll be flipping the bricks. I think it's sales and I'm leaving you hit. I'll be the problem, you gotta solve this. Like in that weed, no, I would've tossed it. Better be handy, so hydro or kush. Anything less, well, I promise no push. Light up, you got a problem on the back on the scene. I push that green in a sip codeine. I'm loving that purple like I'm married to the bitch. And I flip a few times, then I'm gonna have to switch. Oh my, so high, man, I'm gonna have to sit. I take a few hits, and I'm back to the shit. I don't ever quit, cause I know they miss. I love that weed, so I'm gonna have to spit. How else am I gonna set up hold my habit? Without this green, I'll be bouncing like a rabbit. Keep on feeling while I look inside. Put them on paper, that's how I survive. Burning this shit, business and shit. I got the monkeys, made us so hit. Sipping some beer and some vodka, that's it. Made us so high, made us so lit.
Made up happy, made up happy, made up happy, made up happy.
I love the smoke weed
in hand.
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 Made up happy,
get high.
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 I love the smoke weed
in hand.
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 Made up happy. Made up happy, made up happy, made up happy.
I love the smoke weed
in hand.
I love the smoke weed
in hand.
I love the smoke weed
in hand.
I love the smoke
weed
in
hand. Let go. Soldiers be loving my chip because all that I bring will be shit that's legit. I don't see you no sense in no stick. Just give me a Dutch and I'm rolling up thick. Let it fire and then I'm a pass. They definitely go hold it until the last. They can't see a thing with me now that don't matter. I'm only here to take wreck in the chatter. I'm like Superman because I'm flying this bitch. I'm not gonna...
And you're tuned into another episode of To Be Blunt with Pete.
That's right. Such an asshole, bro.
Yeah. I'm somehow going to make a TikTok of this, yeah? Everyone just pop up and like...
We can make bad TikToks of that shit.
Yeah, we're going to have to pull it. And make That's Right TikToks.
Go to TikTok in a sec.
Just point at everything throughout life, you know?
Yeah, you're right. That's right. It's going around.
Pulling up at Taco Bell.
That's right. Yeah. That's my gimmick, bro. That's my gimmick. Don't hate.
You're going to say That's Right at the drive-thru menu?
Why not? Yeah. I said That's Right to anything. It's appropriate for any situation.
Any situation.
Absolutely.
Big, large.
That's right.
Small, monumental.
That's right. See?
Epic, you know?
That's right. That's right. That's right. There could be many different ways to say it.
That's what Paige probably said when she used that belt as a cum plate. That's right.
Yeah. Fucking cum plate.
See you guys on the cum plate, yo.
So
Frank, do you want to do your top five, bro? Your cereal bars?
I've been thinking about these edibles all week. I've been eating cereal, thinking about how much I love cereal when I'm high, and I'm probably
sure,
gonna be
you, like,
eating cereal free, when I'm for dinner tonight.
So. Why don't you let them know that?
Stoned.
Frank Knox top five. I don't know what's going on here, but we're back. Frank Knox top five cereals. When you're stoned.
Yeah, let's hear it. Your Frank Knox top five cereals, number five.
Yabba dabba doo! It's none other than the Fruity Pebbles, baby!
Number four.
You know I'm a sucker for peanut butter and those Reese's Puffs!
Oh, God, no Puffs!
Number three.
I don't know. It's a little controversial. Some people may hate it, but I'm a fan of a good old-fashioned corn pop.
The corn pops?
Gotta have my pops. All right, number two,
Cookie Crisp.
Okay. And your Frank Knox number one cereal is
CTC, baby. Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, the Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
The milk after the Cinnamon Toast Crunch brings it to another level, baby. You ever have Cinnamon Toast Crunch? I'm sure you have.
Of course I have. It's my number one. It's my number one.
The milk, right? How good's the milk?
Yeah. The milk at the end's the best.
Like, when you finish the cereal, if there's still milk, you're not done. Because that extra cinnamon in that milk,
whew, that's the best part.
It's the best part, man.
It's the same thing with, like, a chocolate cereal. You get the chocolate milk at the end. It's like, fuck yeah. I'm fucking high.
That's also true. I think I'm in the same boat you are.
That's right.
Do you hear about this new cereal that's coming out soon, though? The All Together?
You mentioned this already on this podcast.
That's right, Scott. Pay attention.
Well, never mind.
RPG has.
That's right. We're going to go into the new parody. It's been a few weeks since we've heard of parody. You already know. The Dankovich.
Yep, Dankovich in the building.
I go, I find the hottest pop songs, you can, whatever kind of songs, and I make them into weed songs.
Weed.
Hell yeah. That's what we
That's
do.
That's fucking awesome.
I know, right?
It's weed sell Dankovich.
That's right. Every song you've heard of play on this podcast so far has been me. So,
oh, that's dope.
Yeah.
What?
That's yeah.
Lit. Every somebody, song.
Every single.
Some of these shits have been hot.
I know, yo. You don't know about Peasy? You'll find out.
I've learned today.
Yeah, that's right. You're going to learn today.
I'm going to learn
today. The Jack of all
gimmicks. This isn't exactly Peasy. This. I found this great song. I'm listening. I'm in the car with my wife. I love that woman. I'm sitting in the car, and she got the song that comes on. She likes to listen to the pop stations, you know. And it's fucking this Shawn Mendes guy.
Damn, everyone's stuttering.
Stuttering.
Stuttering Stanley. Stuttering Stanley.
Wow, do you know that song, Senorita?
Oh, I love that song.
You like that song? You heard the song, Senorita?
Shawn Mendes, bro?
Yeah, Shawn Mendes.
Yeah, no, I've heard it.
You heard the song. So I hear this song, bro. Thanks, and I'm bro. Like, I have to turn this into a weed track. They're talking about Senorita, you know? Love it when you call me Senorita. I'm thinking to myself, I love it when you smoke in sativa.
First thing in the morning.
That's right. So, and we smoke sativa right here in the L tonight.
Light it off with a sativa.
That's right, on a sativa. So right here, exclusive 2B1 podcast, Peasy and the Mrs.
Frank. Mr. and Mrs. Dankovich.
It's sativa.
Smoke la la la, yeah. Oh, I'm sitting beachside, I'm watching sunsets, drinking no tequila sunrise, and now my hands are sticky from la la la. I'm in the club, la la la, yeah. I love it when you're smoking on sativa. I wish I could pretend I didn't need some. So let me hit that ooh la la la. I smoke la la la. Ooh, my mind be running. Ooh, I think I'm higher when I'm smoking on sativa. I wish I could pretend I didn't need some. So let me hit that ooh la la la. I smoke la la la. Ooh, my mind be running.
I'm in a hotel, there's just no way for me to find the bud that I need. You know that weed I need, it tastes la la la. Cause you know it's been a long time coming when you see me call. Ooh, when I hear your voice I'm hooked, you're the one. Roll up a blunt, we blowing shots.
I love it when you're smoking on sativa. I wish I could pretend I didn't need some. So let me hit that ooh la la la. I smoke la la la. Ooh, my mind be running. Ooh, I think I'm higher when you're smoking on sativa. I wish I could pretend I didn't need some. So let me hit that ooh la la la. I smoke la la la.
Yeah, she loves when I call
her loud.
2B Blood Podcast. Another hit in the books. Smoking Sativa. What do you think, Frank?
It was my favorite one today. It was great. It was
awesome. Favorite one to date? There's been a lot of good ones.
I don't know.
It was really good. It sounded like a real fucking song. Yeah.
It featured more of Mrs. Dankovich than normal, so I enjoyed it.
That's true. I don't know. There's been a few good ones. I like it.
Yeah.
I don't know if I can pick a favorite yet.
So far, my front runner is
Sativa.
They're all in like YouTube and shit. Like, I'll
send you the links.
Yeah. Funny.
That's great. That awesome. 2B Blood Podcast. Chef Goof, thank you for coming in.
Yeah, thank you for having me in Connecticut. I love you. You'll always be home.
Right. If you can find him on Facebook, Instagram.
All that good shit.
At Goof Drop. You already know.
Yeah, man.
Follow us on Facebook. Much. Yes, thank you.
Dude,
thank you, man.
The edibles are really good.
I'm about to snack heavy when we get done here. I got to stop, bro. If I do it during the show, fuck.
I didn't turn the show. I ate all my snacks, my wings, my empanada.
Drink that
I'm still snacking. I drank my whole cup of lean. I'm fucked up
right
now.
I'm going to go home and go to bed.
Even the sky got put it down.
Yeah. I got smoky in here. We got lit.
I need those empanadas with or without weed. Those empanadas.
We're fired.
I kill it.
Dude, I'm beef and cheese shit. I swear to God, I'm not going to eat a whole plate of them things.
I'll come back and cook for you guys. You guys want to do like an infused dinner or something one time. Dude,
we got to do it.
We'll do it up.
It's like Franklin Avenue, Columbia.
We should sell tickets to do an infused dinner.
We'll do like a four-course dinner. We got that shit.
That'd be sick, bro. And we'll do it on the podcast. Everything upstairs and get the dining room table set up.
Dude, we'll have like a red carpet and shit, dude, where people have to like take pictures. Like, we'll do all the waitress walking around giving around joints and shit. Like, that's right. I know what time it is.
I know what time it is, too. It's time for all you to subscribe, review, like us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, at 2B Blood Podcast with the number 2. 2BBloodPodcast.com. I'm your host, Peasy, Frank Knox, the Scott Chef Goof.
Yes.
We'll see you next week. Same weed time, same weed channel.